Revelation chapter 8, the seventh seal. And when he had opened the seventh seal, there was silence in heaven about the space of half an hour. And I saw the seven angels which stood before God, and to them were given seven trumpets. And another angel came and stood at the altar, having a golden censer, and there was given unto him much incense, that he should offer it with the prayers of all the saints upon the golden altar which was before the throne. And the smoke of the incense, which came with the prayers of the saints, ascended up before God out of the angel's hand. And the angel took the censer, and filled it with fire of the altar, and cast it into the earth. And there were voices, and thunderings, and lightnings, and an earthquake. And the seven angels which had the seven trumpets prepared themselves to sound. The seventh seal is opened. Verses 1 through 6 are introductory verses to the seven trumpets about to sound. So we now see that the opening of the seals reveal the seven trumpets. I explained this connection between the seals, trumpets, and vials in the video entitled Laying the Groundwork for Understanding Revelation. If you have the opportunity, please watch it. As we move further into Revelation, we will see the seventh trumpet reveal the seven vials or bowls of God's final judgments, which ultimately leads to the second advent of our Lord Jesus Christ. People are deceived into believing God's prophecies have been laying dormant for almost 2,000 years, with not so much as a peep or a whisper. They are fooled into believing that almost the entire book of Christ's revelation to John the Apostle will come spilling over, one on top of the other, during a literal 7-year period somewhere out in the future. The irony is, they won't be here to see it, because they believe Almighty God will whisk them away prior to tribulation or to its fulfillment. So ask yourself this question. If Jesus Christ plans on rapturing the Christian church before the vast majority of Revelation unfolds, and that only the wicked and godless are left behind to face a most certain agonizing death, why would Jesus Christ take the time to have John chronicle the visions? Understand, if the secret rapture people are right, they will never see the fulfillment of Revelation. No one will, because the godless who are supposedly left behind couldn't give a hoot about the Bible to begin with, and they're just wallowing in global misery. Do you understand the point I'm trying to make? He gave us Revelation for a purpose, not just to give John something to do while he's imprisoned on Patmos. But when we read scriptures, let scriptures interpret itself, and compare what God has given us with historical studies, we see the hand of Almighty God at work. We have a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto ye do well that ye take heed, as to a light that shineth in a dark place, until the day dawn, and the day star arises in your hearts. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the Scripture is of any private interpretation, for the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, but holy men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. In the seals we saw the destruction of the persecuting Roman government as a retributive judgment for the millions of Christian martyrs murdered. Now we are warned of the seven trumpets about to sound. Why? To signal the complete overthrow of the Roman Empire of the Caesars. These are the legs of iron in Daniel 2. Thou, O king, sawest, and behold, a great image. This great image, whose brightness was excellent, stood before thee, and the form thereof was terrible. This image's head was of fine gold, his breast and his arms of silver, his belly and his thighs of brass, his legs of iron, his feet of iron and part clay. The Roman Empire is also identified in Daniel 7. After this I saw in the night visions, and behold, a fourth beast, dreadful and terrible, and strong exceedingly, and it had great iron teeth. It devoured and brake into pieces, and stamped the residue with his feet of it. And it was diverse from all the beasts that were before it, and it had 10 horns. The images in both Daniel 2 and Daniel 7 represent the same Roman Empire of the Caesars. As we hear the first four trumpets sound, we see the destruction of the western part of the Roman Empire at the hands of the Goths, Vandals, Huns, and Heruli. As we move into chapter 9 of Revelation, we hear the sounding of the fifth and sixth trumpets. Judgment comes to the Eastern Empire by a new religious and political power rising in the East, Islam.